Hi everybody! Today I'm going to teach you how to make this cute little origami snail. Isn't that adorable? Get it up close to you so you can see what you're making. Let me turn it around. Did you see the other side? Yeah, that's what we're going to do right there. I don't have any dollar bills, so I'm going to be using a $20 bill. But for the sake of you learning how to make it, I'm going to do it two times. I made this one bill that's bigger, so you can really see. I cut the paper so it's bigger so that you can see what's being done. And so I'm going to try it with this, and then I'm going to switch over to the dollar. I mean, to the $20. Okay, start with, you're going to fold this thing entirely in half. Matter of fact, I think I should cut that a little bit smaller. Hang on a second. Let me just cut this paper a little bit smaller. It just looks a little big to me this way. Okay, that looks better. Okay, we're going to fold this in half. Let me get this yellow paper. Okay, we're going to fold this in half, then we're going to make that line crease in there real good. See? Got it all folded in half. That's it. That's all you do there. Then we're going to open up the paper like this, and we're going to take this side of the paper right here, and we're going to make a point right here, and fold this right down on the other side. Just like that. All I did is fold that straight down like that. Then I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. I open it up and I'm going to turn the paper and fold it the opposite direction. I'm going to have a point here and I'm going to lay it right down like that. And put a nice crease in there. Now, as you can see, I put two creases. I've got one there, and I've got one on the other side, just like that. Now I'm going to fold it right here, right across here. I'm going to fold the edge up here down to that line. It'll give me a... Or you can go by this, and you'll get the same effect. If you go by that center, you know, see the center dot there? You can fold it down to that center dot, and that does the same thing. Just measure with the sides of your paper to make sure it's meeting at the sides. See? Now you've got the... this design right now. And then I am going to just push right in. Now if you see how it is right there, I'm going to fold this the opposite direction real quick. You do the same thing. It'll make it easier for what I'm going to show you next. Okay, now that I folded it in the other direction, it looks like it's going in, right? Well, I want you to let it go in. Just fold it, push your fingers right down like that. See what I did? I just put my finger, here's the house, and I put my fingers right on there and push down and right against the house. Then I'm going to lay it down on the paper, just like that, and then I'm going to push this right down on top of it. That's the easiest way to make that fold. And just make go down hard like that. See, you're going to be like that on one side. You're going to be like that on the other side. And that's just from folding that down. All I did was push those sides in and folded it down like that. Then crease it real good. See? The next move, I'm going to take this corner and make it meet with that corner right there, but stay behind that line. I'm going to fold this straight up. This piece here is going to fold straight up and touch the tip, but it's not going to go over that line. I'm going to try to get it as close to the tip as that. It won't go all the way, but I'm going to try to get close to the tip. Just like that. See how that is? I pushed it right up. That was a corner just like this corner, and I just pushed it straight up like that. Well, we're going to do that with this side now. We're going to push this up to the top, just like that, and crease it. And crease it down on the bottom. It's kind of hard to do up in the air. Let me make it more even. Just like that. See? Now you've got a big square box right there. At that point, we're going to take this corner right here, and we're going to bring it right to the middle right there. And stop before you get over that line. Do not go over the line. I'm going to lay it down here. I want to keep it in the camera's view. I'm going to fold this over just like that and crease it. See what I did there? Let me bring it up. I just folded it straight over and had it touch the line. That's all I did. Now I want to do the same thing on the other side. Move this one and bend it to where it goes right down to that line and have it meet the other one. I gotta lay it down to do that because I want it to point at the other one. See there? Now I got them both pointing at each other, just like that. All I did was I took that little square and I bent those two pieces inward. So now there's two squares, a square down here and a square up here. Okay, that's where you are. Now, from this point, I'm gonna take, see how you got two little loose pieces right here? Got two little loose pieces right there on the top. See those? Now I am going to take that little piece right there and I'm just going to lay it down right on top. As far as it'll go down, right on top and crease it. See what I did there? I just folded it right down on top of that one. That's all I did. Now I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. Let me set it down for a minute because I want to get a good crease in there. The creases really make it easier for you to do this job. This is one of the hard parts of doing the snail, and people don't realize there's an easier way to do it. So I have an easier way now. Then you take this piece right here. See how you got another corner and you got another corner? I want those corners to meet that corner. To make it a smaller triangle. Like, don't unfold it, just leave it just how it is. Just like that. Now I just folded that one. I folded it right. See, there it is. I just folded that right on top of that. Just like that. I'm gonna do the same thing with the other side. I'm just gonna fold it right on top of the, see? No biggie. Now I'm squishing it down to make sure the fold's in there good. See? That's all I did. Got two little folds, right like that. And I just folded them straight over, just like that. Now's the part that tricks people a lot, is if you lift this up a little bit, you're going to notice, if you lift this up, you're going to see that your folds, wait a second, that your folds have created a little place that has a pocket in it. See right here? That's if you lift up that little one you just made, that little triangle. You're going to see that little pocket right there. See that pocket? If you push it with your finger or thumb or something, you're going to see that it'll open. See how that opens? You're going to let that little piece drop right down into that hole. right down into that opening. Just like that. People don't realize it can be this easy, but it can be just that easy. Now you're going to do the same thing on this side. See your little triangle? Just push it up just so that you can find the pocket. Just pull it up. And then we're going to find the pocket. Right? Can you see it? It's hard for me to do it. I'm trying to show you as well. So I'm watching the camera while I'm doing this. Let me get it started so I can show you. Easier with my finger. Okay. There we go. Okay, see the pocket? And there's your triangle. Now you're going to push that little triangle. Let me just do it with my fingers to show you that it can be done with your just your fingers. I'm going to just push that right in there. See there? Isn't that simple? People always do these different moves that make it so much harder. Now that's all you got to do with that part. That's that hard part that everybody has a hard time with. I'm just sticking it down in there a little deeper. There. See how you've got, all you've done is you took that little triangle you made and you pushed it down into, the little triangle you made and you pushed it right down into that place right there. Pretty cool, huh? Okay, now, let me think. Oh, I've lost my mind for a minute. Okay, now, you see, I'm going to turn this down to where you got an arrow. See your arrow? Whoop. That's your arrow. Turn it around. And you'll notice that on this little area on the bottom, you've got little, let me get my pointer, you got little folds right there. I want you to lay this against that fold, like this. I want you to bring it up toward that fold and just hold it right there. Then I want you to make this line and this line meet at the top. I want them to be even. You're going to make those meet. See? Now you don't need to fold it any further than that. That's all you need is right there where that where your little bend started. That's all you need is that little bend right there. Oop. So there's the bend you made. There's the crease you made right there. And that's exactly what we wanted. Then we're going to go over the other side and do the same thing. See how you've got that little bend right there? You're going to bend the paper toward that bend. See how I'm going toward the bend? Now I'm just going to hold it until I get these two even. And then I'm going to get these papers even. Once I got those even, I can go back and I can fold that down. See? Now you can always move the film back if you're having a hard time with this. Now you've got like a little square there if you look on the back side. Because of the folds you made. And then on the front, see how you've got that like that? Now what I'm going to want you to do is I'm going to want you to go back to the other side over here. And I want you to fold it backwards on the color. I just want you to fold it backwards like this. Just to make sure you got a good crease in there. See how nice that is? Nice crease in there. Then you're going to turn it up like this and see how you've got these little lines right there? I want you to pull those backwards, down and, wait a second, oh, I want to go the other way, sorry. Okay, I want you to push this part. See how you've got it like this? I want you to push this. Just bend right here. Bend. See how it looks like a house right there, right on that edge? If you push it this way, it looks like a house. I want you to just put a fold right there. That's it. That's a better way to do it. See how I put a fold right there where it looked like a... where it looked like a house. Fold it like that. And then over here, I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to bend that house roof just like that. See how I bent those two? Those are the two folds that you just made. Now that you've got those like that, all you got to do is push down on the middle and you can close it up. See? That's everything you've made so far. Doesn't matter which way this is going because you're going to do the same thing on both sides. Now, what I'm going to want you to do is see that little point right there? Right there. I want you to fold that right up to that line, but don't go over the line. I want you to do that on both sides. I'm going to turn it my way so that you can, so the camera can see it good. Here, let me try to get you closer to me. Okay, now you're closer to me. Now I'm going to bend this straight down, but not go over the line. See? See? But don't go over the line. Looks like it, but it's not over the line. Then I go the other side, do the same thing. Just bend that down right to the line. See, I'm getting close. A little bit more. Now I've got it there. See how that is? Now I want you to go over to this open side right here. Don't pull it open. I want you to flatten this like this. Open it up. You're going to have two little pieces on this side, two little pieces on this side. Now that that's open like that, just bend them all the way over. Just like that. And then stick your finger in here, come all the way up, and put your thumb on top of this. Just like that, see? My finger went in there and pulled it up. And then I'm just going to push on this back side. I'm going to push it down. And if you'll notice, when I push it down, I want it to meet that line. So I'm going to scoot it over a little bit before I push those, make folds. I'm going to push that over to where it meets the middle. See how there's a middle line right there? And there's the middle line of this. It just meets. And then I'm going to do some pushing down of this. Now I'm going to scrape my corners in to where it turns out like that. Now all I did, I'm going to go back. I'm going to pull this back up because I want you to see what was done. It was like this, okay? This was up like this. That's the way it was after you folded those tips up. Remember the tips? Then I just opened it up. I stuck my finger in here. And I held on to that. I held onto it with my fingers in it, and I just pushed it down to the ground. And then I squashed these out. I just want to make sure you got that. You can always go back and look again, and we're going to do it again when we do it with the $20. Okay, and then I want this one. See that little, see where the fold is right there? See that fold right there? I want you to fold it from this point up to this point right here. Up to this point right here. But I want to make sure this point stays perfect. I don't want it overlapped. I want it to just come to it. The bottom doesn't matter as much. So you're gonna want to probably start right there. Can you see? Okay, and then you're gonna put a little bump there, see? And then you're just gonna lay the whole thing down. Put a crease. Just like that. Let me get a different colored paper to go underneath because it's starting to get kind of not showy. Okay, now you can see it. Okay, we're going to do the same thing with the other side. But I'm going to fold this back first to the line, just so that I can see my fold real good. It's really nice to keep seeing your fold down here because you're going to be working with this area a little bit. Okay, right here. Now, this is the antenna. This is going to be the antenna of your snail. That's why I want to point there. And right here. We're working on the antennas right now. So let's start bending that. And make sure it doesn't go over. That one went over a little bit. Let's try it again. Okay, right there. And then bend it right down to there. And then put your fold in there. Then I'm going to bend this back to the line again because I want to keep seeing the line. Because I have more folds. You don't have to have this. You can, whichever way you like it. I like being able to see the lines. See how you can see the lines there? You could even fold the whole thing to make sure you see those lines. I just need to see the lines really well. Because we're still going to fold down on that line. Can you see that? We're still going to fold down on that line again with this side. Okay, now I am going to lift. See this here? I'm going to lift that up. I'm going to grab this side, and I'm going to fold it right down that line again. See that line? And right against this. That's why I had to pull it over. There it is. And then I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. I'm going to turn this around. And I'm going to loop, move this up just like that. And I'm going to fold this right over to the line. See there? And just kind of scratch your fold down. Now you're going to be like this. If it doesn't look like that, you've got a problem. You need to go back. See there? You folded both of these sides in. See where you folded it? Now I want you to open that back up. Right here. And right here. Because we did that just for fold lines to start with. And then we're going to make fold lines of another one so that we can do our next move. Okay, so now, instead of folding this in, I'm going to fold the top in. Fold that open again, and fold the top from this point right here. This whole side is going to lay up against this. Okay, just like that. Get a good crease in there. See? I folded this over, and I just laid the whole thing from here to here. Now we're going to do the same thing on this side. Move it over the other side. Move that. This is actually the top of the shell of a snail. The top shell part right there. That's the top. This an antenna. This is the tail right there. Okay, now I'm going to move this down and try to get it close to the other one. Doesn't have to be perfect, but I try to get them close. As you can see, my folds weren't perfect because it's not perfect. Okay, now you should have, it should be like this. Now it should look kind of like this. Mine's a little uneven, but that's all right. Their antennas aren't even anyway.
now I'm going to open this back up like that.
Now I've got it open again. Now if you turn it over, you're going to notice that you've got new lines. See how we've got a V right there? Well, let me see. Can you see it? See that V right there? I'm going to pull right where that V is. I'm going to try to squash that just outward a little bit. There's the inside. Here's the outside. And the outside is the way I want it squashed out. From that little point, I want that squeezed out to the tip. That's the antenna. I'm going to do the same thing on the other side. See where that line is? I'm going to fold it right there just to put a fold outward. See? Now I'm going to take a hold. Well, I'm going to turn it this way. I'm going to take a hold of that fold, take a hold of that fold, and I'm going to make both of those lines that I folded down come in right up against the snail's body and close it off. Just like that. Oh, I'm getting out of view here. Okay, you see what I did? Where those folds fold in, when I grabbed this and I folded this in, well, when I grabbed it from the outside, when I squashed that, it made a diamond. When you turn it over and I pushed the top part that I'd already folded in and the bottom part that I already folded in back in. I pushed both of those back in, and now these are the antennas for the snail. I know it doesn't look like it yet, but you're just about done. Now, I'm going to take this part of the snail, and I'm going to fold that in half to go up. Just like that. See how I folded that up? It makes a diamond. It makes another diamond when you fold it up like that. I'm going to fold it up, and then I'm going to push everything down real tight, real nice and tight. I'm going to move this guy a little bit, just so he's straighter. That's where you should be right now. That's just from that fold. That's just from taking this and folding it half. From this side. From this side, all you did was you folded that back in like that. Now, I'm going to lay it down like this. And see how you've got these little places here? I want you to, this is the antennas. I am just going to fold this part right here down against the line. Just to make my antennas smaller. You don't have to do that. I prefer them smaller. I like the way my, just like that. Just like, see how I folded that in? That was like that, and I folded it in down like that. Now you've got a longer antenna here, a thinner antenna. Now I'm going to do the same thing with the other side. This your last, well, almost your last fold. I'm going to fold that down like that. See, now I got both of them folded down. Can you see it? Now I'm going to take the whole thing right here. I don't need to grab the top, but I'm going to take just this part and fold this in half. Just like put both ends against each other and push them together. Yep. Both ends, push them together. Just like that. It's your snail's body. A little scratch it in place.
This is a heavier paper I'm working with than the dollar. That's why it's harder for me to fold. You'll have an easier time with the dollar. Okay, now after I've done that, I'm going to turn it over, and your snail is basically done now. All I got to do is bend these so that they look cute. I'm going to kind of twist them a little bit. Kind of twist the other side. I think they look cute twisted. Ooh, I twisted it the wrong way. See? That's your antennas. Now, this is your tail. And what I want you to do with the tail is I want you just to bend it down for now. Just bend that whole tail down for a minute. It'll make it easier for what you're going to do next. This is the last part. See, right, if you'll notice right here, right in the back, right where the tail was, you're going to see a hole right there. That hole? I want you to blow air into that. Just put it up to your mouth and blow air in it. Now, I blew some air into mine. And then I kind of push on the front. And I pull his tail back out. Now, if you don't like the idea of blowing air, I pull down on this also. I pull this back down so that the shell sits against my snail. You know, you can blow in there better. I don't know if I can do that. Did you see it come? Well, did you see it? I hope you saw that. But see, I just blew up the shell. Now, what I like to do is I like to push in right here just to get a nice flat place on the front of the snail. And then, this came out. That goes underneath. Now, if your snail's not coming up all the way, it works better with the dollar. Just stick something in there and push it out. I like to blow it. Then on the end of the tail right here, I like to bend it. Just put a little creases in with my finger. And move it upward. Just like that. And there's your snail. But you need more air in this one. Hang on a second. This one just didn't want to blow up. There it goes. There it goes. Now it blew up. That's because I had a hole in it. That's why it wasn't blowing up. I got a little rough with it. Okay, there you go. Now he's showing his true colors. Okay, there's that one. I'm going to bend these antennas up just a little more. I like them to have a little bit more character. See there? And then there's the other one that I had just... Here's the other one I had just made. See how cute those are? Let me show you this one. See, that's right where you folded in when you made the antennas. And then because of the way you folded it, it came out white on the bottom and the blue on the top. Because we made the shell part first. So whichever color you want to be on the outside, you're going to have to make sure that that color is showing when you're doing the shell. Because the rest of it is all body. All the rest of the folds is body. Your first part is going to be the shell. Okay, now I'm going to grab the $20 bill. Okay, here we go. Here we go, girlfriend. Okay, now with this one, I want this on the top. That part. Let's put him there so that you can see him. So you can watch those little guys crawling around while we're working. There you go. And then we're going to fold it in half like we did before. Now I have to say, it's going to be easier working with the $20 bill. I mean, with any bill. Just like that. Fold it in half. Then I'm going to open it up. Now, if you don't remember these moves, go back to the beginning and start again. Then you go over this way, and you can do it right with me while I'm doing it. So hang on to this video, because I don't think you're going to find one that shows you any clearer than this. Then I did that fold there. Now I'm going to go the other side and do the fold on the other side, straight down. Good crease. You want to make sure on the bills that you're putting a good crease, just like that. Then straight down, you're going to be matching it with, you're going to be matching it right there with that point. See the point there? See that point? That's where we're going to match it to. And match it with the sides as well at the same time. Now we got all of our little marks in there. Remember how we had all those marks in our paper? Now we've got it on this. Now you're going to fold this the opposite way just to get that same crease, just to get that crease folded in so that the bill works with you. Then we're going to fold this in. Remember how we folded it in? We're going to fold this in. Do look back on the other video if you don't get this, because I'm trying to go faster for time's sake. I'm trying not to get too fast, though, on you. Okay, now you're going to make sure those creases are in there real good. Now, remember when you were at this point where you had these little flaps? Now we're going to move those flaps up to the top here. Just like this. Get the other side. Just like that. Now you got your little square like we talked about before. Now you're going to take this point to the center. Like that. Other side. Oh, I've got to get my hands on it. I'm trying to get the best view for you, but it's kind of hard sometimes. Okay, just like that. See there? Now we got those in. Let me put it up close to you. See, now we got those ends in. Now what comes next? Okay, the next thing is taking these flaps. Remember these? Remember these little flaps? What do we do with those? We fold them right down on the pocket. I'm going to get this one. Yep, where is it? Up here. I'll fold this one down on the pocket. Take a look. Take a look-a-see. Remember that point? Now we're going to take the point and we're going to fold it down to make a small triangle. Remember, this is going to be tucked in. Let's do it on the other side too. You don't want an uneven $20 bill. There you go. Now we got to find our pockets. Let me get that camera up higher again. There we go. It's easier for me. Okay. Now we're going to just move those out of the way for a minute. Just so we can find our pockets. Remember where the pockets are?
The pockets are right here, right in here. See? That was real easy to find that one. Now let's find the other one. There's the other one. There's those two pockets that everybody has trouble with. What do we do next? We fold our little triangles down into the pockets. Easier with your fingers. See how I push that in there? Not a biggie. Then push this one into this one. Ah, I got caught in my fingernail. Now they're both in there. Squish them in real good. You can always take your nail and push them against it like this to make sure it's in there really good. Now we're making the shell right there. That is the shell. This part of your snail. Now what I'm going to do is I got to deal with these corners here. Now if we don't do those, it's not going to work well for you. Remember what we do with that. We fold our dollar up and hang on to that like that. All we're doing is folding it against this part right here. That's what we're folding the dollar against. Then we come up here and make sure these two sides match when we put the crease, and then we put the crease in. Go the other side. See the crease? Now we go to this side. Fold your dollar up onto that crease and hang on to it. And then match your sides. And crease it. Now you got your little square. Now we're going to fold the whole dollar in half again. Just so we can get a nice crease in here. And then, we folded it the wrong way. We fold the dollar the opposite way and get a nice crease in it. Oh, you're bound to. Nobody's perfect. But everybody's special. Okay, now that's the way you should have folded it. Now, when you open that up, you've still got your lines that are hard to see. You can see them on the other side. See those lines there? Okay, you're going to want to push I'm going the wrong way. You're going to want to push. You know, just like that. And you know what? Just bend your dollar over like in the beginning. I keep forgetting to tell you that to make that little house. You want to bend that like that. Because then it goes down a lot easier. Oh, well, shoot, I'm not showing you. After you've got that fold in there, then you bend just that little part again to make your square. See? And then let it come down to make your house. See the little house? Then you're going to be bending the little houses down one side at a time just to meet that line at the, just to meet the top of the ridge of the house. Like that. Down to the edge. Same thing on the other side. See? Now you're going to want to open that up. I'll put your finger in here or your thumb. Let's go with my thumb. I'll put my thumb in the open part of the dollar. I'm going to bring up my finger up and hold on to this.
Then I'm going to push against this part of the dollar to make it fold down. Like that. Then I'm going to make sure that this meets right in the middle. This looks confusing, but once you get used to making it, it's really quick after you get used to making it.
Yeah, right. Look how you're doing it.
No, it is easy once you get used to it.
There, like that. Now all you got left is you've got the shell done.
That's the top right here. You've already got that done. That's all that work goes in the shell. Now you just got to do the body and the antennas. This is the tail, antennas, and body. So I'm going to fold. Remember how I told you to fold right to that tip? I'm going to fold this up to that tip right there. And I'm going to make sure that I have a point on the antenna. Just like that. It's more important that this is right.
It's more important for that to be nice and sharp than it is for this.
Okay, let's do the other side.
At this point, you should have a diamond on the other side. Cool? Okay, now we're going to fold this in again to the middle.
But I like to, as I told you before, I like to have a fold that I can see real good. So I am going to fold this in half and crease it so I have a nice line to follow. I don't like not being able to see. Now I can see that line real good now. See the line right down the middle? Ew. Now I'm going to fold. I'm going to move this upward.
Move the shell up. Can you see that? I'm moving the shell up like this, all to one side. And I'm going to move this down
right next to it.
Like that. And then I can let go of it and it can go on top of it. See?
Now I'm going to get the other side, this side here. Fold it down, move the shell over, fold it down like that. Then your shell can come back over. I want to
show you how that looks. Just like that. And that's just from folding those two sides up like that. Right against the shell. See? I went right against the shell. Now you're going to open it up because you got to do the top part, remember?
And we're going to move that over and do the top part. We're putting a good crease in there because that's the crease you got to see. Now we're going to move it, turn it around the other way. And we're going to turn that over like that. Oops. That's the shell I'm moving sideways. Now we're going to do the top the same way. The way I try to get the antennas close is try to make that line match up with that line. And then I sharpen it right there. Okay, that's done with that folding. Now I want to unfold this, and I want to turn it over so that I can see where my lines are. Now, there's my line for my first fold, and there's my line for my second fold. So I want to pinch this out where that bottom point and that top point are the fold. I want to fold it there. Just to the edge. Let me show you that. Now I folded it right where that tip matches with the top tip. Now I'm going to go the other side and do the other side. Okay, now on this side, where is it? Ah, there it is right there. And right there. And that's just from those two folds where I folded this side over and folded this side over. That's where you get that little V. And you want that bent, that V and that tip to be pointed out because that's your antenna. Like that. Now I'm going to turn it over this way and I'm going to grab a hold of this V part and this part, these two antennas, and I'm going to push everything down behind the shell and then down for the body to where I'm folding those folds back in that I already made. Now I've still got the antennas right here, and I've still got the shell right here. Now everything's folded in. Let me see, let me show you what I got left. That's what I got left right there. There's the two antennas. This is the tail down here. Body and shell. Now I'm going to hold on to this right here, and I'm going to just turn this backwards, fold it in half. Can you see what I'm doing? I'm going to fold it in half. Let me show you the other way. Here's this side. I'm going to turn it around. And see the smooth side? The smooth side, I'm just going to fold in half up this way to where it's smooth now. It's no lines right there. And it's going to make you another little diamond. Okay, let's make sure that that's straight. And it's coming out pretty straight. This one's going to be a nice one. Now, you got those lines all creased in there real good. Then you're all ready to go. You're almost done. Now I'm going to make the antennas a little thinner just by folding this into that middle line. There we go. And then over here to the middle line. If you don't remember these, please go back to the beginning and watch those things. You can move it wherever you want to. And find whatever you need. Now I'm going to fold this whole thing in half, like this. See what I'm doing? And I'm squishing the body right here. Just to make it stay. Now I'm going to, now these are the little antennas. I'm going to just give them a little twist. There's your antennas. This is your shell. Now what I want to do is I like to hold on to the bottom part. See how this shell has two pieces? I like to hold on to the bottom part. Like right here and right here. See those? Now you've just got two on the top there. And I turn it upside down like that. And I'll bend the tail. I'll open it up a little bit and bend that tail down. Now remember how I told you there's a hole for blowing the air in right here. See that? Little hole there. Now I'm going to blow air into it. I forgot to hold that down. Can you see? Did you see that? Well, I don't know if you saw it or not, but I blew into that hole and it made it fat like that. And then I bend up a little piece on the back because I like it. A lot of people like it straight, but I just like a little character there. Now, if any of your parts came back out, just fold them back in where they belong. I'm moving the antennas around because I like them to be real movie. Now, there's your snail. Here's the other one. Let me show you up close. There's the one that I just made. Isn't that cute? Another thing I like to do is I like to take a little paper. Just a little paper. Like that. And then I like to write on them. Write a little message on there. Now on this one, well, you can't tell that, but I wrote Jesus loves you. Then I, or whatever message you want to put on there. And I roll it up. And I stick it right in the hole. See that hole in the back? I stick it right in that hole in the back. Now, if you leave dollars around and you put that in there and you sit them somewhere and somebody finds the dollar, then they see that Jesus loves you. It's just a nice message to send to people. And that one has you can put other things in there if you wanted to, I imagine. But it's just kind of cool. Or you can put things like mommy loves you or you know, just different little things. You know, you're a beautiful person. It's just nice to have those little messages inside. Another thing I like to do is I like to use these fake monies, you know, that have like a message, you know, a gospel message on the back. I like to make these and send these out. These are fun monies to work. To use, and they're the exact same size as your dollars. And I got gobs of them, you see. I found them on eBay. And I just looked under money, fake money, all that kind of stuff, and I found them. You know, or gospel, tracks. Tracks is a good way to find them. But that's how you do that. Well, anyway, I want you guys to enjoy. You know, here's the first one we made, and I don't know if that's the second one, and here's the last one. But anyway, this is what we got, and they're just loads of fun to make, and they turn out so cute, and kids and people just love finding these. Well, anyway, you have a great day, and remember, Jesus loves you.